A great exciting action we're going to see here as Ricky Steamboat and Bad Bad Leroy Brown. As you can see, it's a big coliseum. It's a main event at any arena in the United States. And Bad Bad Leroy Brown is going to be tested in this one, Bill Ward, because he's got Ricky Steamboat on his hands.
Right, Johnny. Here's again where we can say that speed, leverage is going to be important, because that's what Ricky Steamboat is going to have against the man that big.
That's right. He's got to overcome the power and strength and size of Leroy Brown, and it's done with speed and agility, and Steamboat's got all that. You can see the manager of Bad Bad Leroy Brown on the outside, Sir Oliver Humperdink over there, and I think we saw Jay Youngblood, who is strapped to...
Well, he decides he's had enough. He wants to go out and get ready to wrestle now. Ricky Steamboat didn't give him a chance to take off his...
A great onslaught by Steamboat at the beginning of the match, and he's got one thing in his corner, and that's Jay Youngblood, who strapped to Sir Oliver Humperdink. Now, Oliver Humperdink can't get away with a lot of the things that he usually gets away with on the outside of that ring. And I believe of taking a count on the outside, Bad Bad Leroy Brown is confused about this turn of events.
Well, for one thing, I think he's a little confused because he knows the man with the red hair out there cannot help him. And he's going to be in there all alone against Ricky Steamboat. And he's found out that Ricky is going to be a good opponent.
Brown trying to stall. You know, he's the television champion, Bill, and he's trying to stall for some time right here. Ricky only has 15 minutes, and the more he can kill. Now Brown's going to go down, probably to see about Humperdink. He doesn't want Humperdink in the situation that they've got him in. Strapped to Jay Youngblood out there. He can't maneuver. But all the time, that clock is ticking away. That precious 15 minutes you got to defeat Bad Bad Leroy Brown.
Well, you see, he's taking all the time he can possibly take outside that ring. Keeping that clock running, that's the main thing, and he's very reluctant to come back in there against Steamboat after that opening assault that Steamboat made.
Yeah, that could be a ploy of Humperdink, too. He's causing distraction on the outside there, but they know all along the clock is running.
I don't know, there's some altercation going on between Bad Bad Leroy Brown and the referee. Referee says, you better get in here.
Yeah, he wants to press the attack, and he gets Steamboat from the back.
Well, that's one mistake that Ricky made. He had his back turned.
It makes very few. Well, he might have been lulled asleep right there, Bill, of all the time that Humperdink and Brown were killing.
So the strategy by Bad Bad Leroy Brown has worked. And he has Ricky Steamboat in trouble at the moment. You know how methodical that Bad Bad Leroy Brown is?
When he's got the upper hand. And that's the time that Bad Bad Leroy Brown can be at his most dangerous, because he won't give you a second breath out there. He's going to stay right on top of Steamboat, and he's got him locked in reverse chin lock right now.
This Ricky Steamboat makes a good representation of his state of Hawaii. Well thought of all over the United States.
One of the most popular wrestlers who put on tights in recent years. You can see the crowd outside there. They're all cheering for Ricky. Also watching the antics of Sir Oliver Humperdink in the corner. But Jay's out there. He's got his eye on Humperdink, and he's got that strap to his wrist. And now it's just Ricky has to get out of this hold. And you can see Bill right there. Ricky is a fine specimen of an athlete. But you see how much bigger that Leroy Brown is. He's giving away a lot of weight.
Well, they're trading him right now, John.
They certainly are.
Steamboat with the advantage now. Great comeback by Steamboat. Boy, those chops have really had taken their toll on the big man.
Buckling his knees, Steamboat's going to send him into that rope. Now down goes the big man. Knee drop, lateral press.
That's a count of two, very close to victory.
And right quickly, before the big man can get up, and there's an half-center Steamboat has in the match very quickly, before the big man can take time to get up, right back on the reverse chin lock.
back to that old...